Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class we studied what are odd numbers, even numbers, right? And we saw how to write the numbers before a given number and after a given number, right? Before and after. So we had started with the chapter fun with numbers, and we covered these topics in the last class. So in today's class we'll be covering comparing of numbers, ascending order and descending order, and something called ordinal numbers and numerals. Okay, so first let us see what we did in the last class. So we saw that the numbers 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 and so on are called as even numbers because they can be made into pairs. Correct? Because the things can be made into pairs, they are called even numbers. So here we saw example with a pair of shoes. So in one pair of shoes there are two shoes, in two pairs of shoes there are four, in three pairs of shoes there are six shoes, in four pairs of shoes there are eight shoes, and in five pairs there are 10. So using these shoes you can make pairs. Correct? That is why they are called even numbers. So any number with 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 are even numbers. Correct. So the numbers ending with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0 are called as even numbers. Then we saw what are odd numbers. So when you make pairs, if something is left over, okay, so that when a number is left over after making pairs, then that is called as an odd number. See here, so one glove. So it doesn't make a pair. One glove cannot make a pair. So one is an odd number. Then three gloves. That is one pair of gloves and one glove is left over. Correct. And here five gloves make two pairs and one is left over. Same way seven gloves make three pairs of gloves and one which will be left over. Correct. Same way nine gloves make four pairs with one left over. Okay, so the numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19 are called as odd numbers. Okay, so when we make odd numbers into pairs, one is left over. Alright, so the numbers ending with 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are called as odd numbers. Okay, so this was odd numbers and even numbers. Then we saw what is before and after. Okay, so before. So I have two numbers here, 1 and 2. So here the number which comes first, which is the number that comes first among 1 and 2, it is 1. So it means that 1 comes before 2. Okay, the number which comes first is called as before. So 1 comes before 2. Then if I take example of 22 and 23. So in numbers 22 comes first and then comes 23. So 22 comes before 23. Okay, so this was one example of before. So 1 comes before 2. And then guess before number. So we did this, right? So here we have 3. So what number comes before 3? Before 3 we have 2. Okay, 2 comes before 3. Then we have 6. So what number comes before 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So just before 6 we have 5. So 5 comes before 6. Then we saw what is the concept of after. So in after, when you have two numbers, here I have two numbers 3 and 4. Then these two numbers, which is a number that comes later on or second? So 4 comes after 3. Correct. So 4 is the number that comes second, so it is called after 3. And then guess after number. So here we have the number 5. So what is the number that comes after 5? So if you see the list above, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 6. So after 5 we have the number 6. Then 7. So what comes after the number 7? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And after 7 we have 8. Okay, so that was 8. So this was before and after. Then between. So here I have three numbers now, 4, 5 and 6. Now between 4, 5 and 6, now here 4 comes before 5, correct? And 6 comes after 5. So just in between 4 and 6, the number is 5. So this is the concept of in between. Okay, so here what is the number between 2 and 4? The number between 2 and 4 is 3. Alright, and here we have 7 and 9. So what is the number that comes between 7 and 9? Number that comes between 7 and 9 is 8. So 7, 8 and 9. Okay, so this is between. So now we'll see how to compare numbers. So that was what we learnt in the last class. And today's class we'll be learning how to compare two given numbers. So which is a greater number, which is a lesser number. Okay, and what are the signs you use to denote greater than and lesser than. So to show greater than, we have already learned comparing numbers, we'll learn it once again. Okay, so here first we'll learn what is equal to. So here we have a set of balloons here. So how many balloons are there in this one set? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 balloons. Then here in this another set, how many balloons I have? Again, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 balloons. So in both the sets of balloons, there are 6 balloons. Okay. So that means there are 6 balloons each. So 6 is equal to 6. So this is the sign of equal to. When there are same number of things, it means that it is equal. Now, so this is another example for equal. So how many fishes are there here? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 fishes. Okay. And here I have 10 ships. So 10 is equal to 10. Okay. Because both are 10 in number, both are equal. Then lesser than. So what's the meaning of lesser than? Now here we have bats and balls. So how many bats are there? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bats. And the number of balls, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 balls. Okay, so now here bats, number of bats, okay, it are 5 and the number of balls are 7. So number of bats are less than the number of balls. Okay, so if 7 children are standing in a playground, okay, I'll give them 5 bats, okay, and I'll give all of them one ball. But now here 5 students have both the bat and the ball, but 2 students will have only the ball. Correct. So it means that 2 bats are less. So the number of bats are less than the number of balls. So this is the sign for less than. Okay, this is how you show less than. So here number of trees is 4 and the number of snowmen are 6. So 4 number of trees is smaller than the number of snowmen. So 4 is less than 6. Okay, then greater than. Now here I have apples and oranges. So how many apples are there? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 apples and oranges 1, 2, 3, 4. Correct. Number of apples are more than the number of oranges. So it means number of apple is greater than number of orange. So this is the greater than sign. Okay, so here we have pineapples. How many pineapples are there? 7. And how many pumpkins are there? There are 3 pumpkins. So pineapples are greater than pumpkins. So we use this sign. So these are the signs. So first one is a greater than sign. The second one is a less than sign. And this is equal to sign. Okay, so this is greater than and less than. So let's see a few questions which are there in your book. Okay, so page number 126 in your textbooks. So here they have asked greater than and less than. Okay, so color the circle with the bigger number. So we have to color the circle which has the bigger number. So here I have 15 and here I have 51. So now which is the number which is bigger? Now in 15, if you see, we see the tens. So in we have 1 10 in 15. And in 51, I have 5 tens. So 5 tens is greater than 15 tens. Correct? So that means 51 is greater than 15. So we'll circle 1. Okay, so we color the circle with the number 51. Now next one. Here I have 49 and 17. So which is a greater number here, 49 or 17? See, 49 has 4 tens and 17 has only 1 ten. So 4 tens is greater than 1 ten. So 49 is greater than 17. Okay, so we circle the number 49. And then next one. So we have 16 and 20. So which is the greater number between 16 and 20? 20 is greater than 16 because it comes after 16. Or you can even compare the number of ones if you want. 10s. So 16 has 1 10 and 20 has 2 10s. So 20 is greater. Then 63 and 36. So which is the greatest number here? 63 or 36? 63 has 6 tens and 36 has 3 tens. So 6 is greater than 3. So 63 is greater than 36. Okay. So we'll do this now. So we color 63. So this was the first question. Now moving on to question number 2. Circle the color with the smallest number. So 16 and 61. So which is the number which is smaller, 16 or 61? 16 is smaller because it has only 1 10. Okay, so we'll color the number 16 on the circle with the smaller number. Okay, you have to color it neatly so that it doesn't come out of the circle. Then 34 and 10. So which is smaller here, 34 or 10? 10 is smaller. Okay, so we'll color 10. Then 33 and 39. So which is a smaller number here among 33 and 39? Between 33 and 39. See, now both have same number of tens, correct? Both have 3 tens. So what you'll do now, you'll check the number of ones. 33 has 3 ones and 39 has 9 ones. So 3 is smaller than 9. So 33 is smaller than 39. So we'll color the circle with the number 33. Okay. Then 81 or 18. So here clearly 18 is smaller. So we'll color the circle with the number 18. Okay. So this is okay. So this is the smaller number. Alright. So this was question 1 and 2. Now look at these two numbers, 18 and 9. Which is a greater number here? 18 is a greater number. So we write it as 18 greater than 9. So this sign means greater than. Okay, this is the greater than sign. Now here in this we have 24 and 17. So which is a smaller number? 17 is smaller. So we write 17 less than 24. So this sign shows less than. Okay, so this is greater than and this is less than. Okay. So the arrow always points to the smaller number. So whenever you're drawing the arrow, draw it such that it points to the smaller number. Okay, so write greater than or less than for the following sets of two numbers. Okay, so we have 37 here and 25. Now, which is the smaller number here? 25 is the smaller number. So make sure that the arrow points towards the smaller number. So this 37 is greater than 25. Then we have 47 and 75. So which is smaller? Now 47 is smaller than 75 or less than. So we use this sign. Okay, the less than sign. Now 96 and 16. First number is 96, second is 16. 96 is greater than 16, correct? So we'll use this sign, the greater than sign. 96 is greater than 16. So if you observe here, the arrow always points at the smaller number. So the pointer is always at the smaller number. So we did these three. Now the next three you all do for homework. Do it as a part of homework. Okay. So this was greater than and less than. Now what we'll do is we'll study what is ascending order and descending order. Okay, so ascending order and descending order. So what's the meaning of ascending order? Whenever ascending numbers, arranging numbers from the smallest to the greatest is called as ascending order. So when a set of numbers are given to you and you have to write the numbers according to smallest to greatest. First you'll write the smallest number, then the second smallest number, and so on. So when you arrange the numbers from smallest to greatest, then it is called as ascending order. So here if you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are 9. So these are all arranged from the smallest, that is being 1, to the largest being 9. So it is nothing but it is same as climbing up the stairs. Okay, then descending order. So when you arrange numbers from the largest number to the smallest number, then it is called as descending order. So in descending order, first we write the greatest number, and then we write the smallest number at the end. Okay, so here we start with 9 and end at 1. 9 is the greatest and 1 is the smallest. So descending order is same as climbing down the stairs. Okay, so this is ascending order and descending order. Now let's see a few questions which are there in your textbook on ascending order and descending order. So page number 127 in your textbook. So ascending and descending order. Okay, so they have told arrange the numbers from the smallest to the largest, that is in ascending order. So one they have done for you. So in this oval there are a few numbers: 74, 99, 43 and 14. So ascending order means smallest to largest. So which is the smallest number in these four numbers now? 14 is the smallest. So first we'll write 14. Then what is the next smallest number after 14? Now 43 is the smallest. So we'll write 43. Then after 43 we have 74. So we write 74, and then we have 99. So we'll write 99 here. Okay, so ascending order is 14, 43, 74 and 99. So now in the next one we have 9, 19, 91 and 69. So here which is the smallest number? When you see we have a one digit number, that is 9. So 9 is the smallest number here. Okay, then after 9 what is the smallest number? Yes, after 9, 19 is the smallest number. So we will write 19 there. So 9, 19. Then after 19 which is the smallest number? 91 or 69? 69 is smaller than 91. So after 19 we'll write 91, and at the end we'll write 69. So the ascending order is 9 19 6 sorry, first we'll write 69 and then we'll write 91. So 9 19 69 and 91. Okay, then next we have 74 98 23 and 15. So here first, which is the smallest? 15 is the smallest. Then after 15, which is the next smallest number? It is 23. And then after 23, we have 74. And after 74, we have 98. So ascending order is 15, 23, 74 and 98. Okay, so next one. 64, 46, 67 and 49. So what is the smallest number here? 46 is the smallest number. After 46, we have 49, then we have 64 and then 67. So 46, 49, 64 and 67 is the ascending order here. Okay, now arrange the numbers from the largest to the smallest, that is in descending order. So they have shown 1. So 39, 31, 14 and 13. So first we'll write the greatest number. Which is the greatest number here? 39 is the greatest number. So we write 39. Then we have, which is the next greatest? 31. So we'll write 31. And after 31, we have 14. And 13 is the smallest. So we'll write 13 last. So 39, 31, 14 and 13. Okay. Then next one. 14, 17, 42 and 19. So which is the greatest number here? 42 is the greatest. And after 42, we have 19. And then we have 17. And then last we have 14. Okay, so the descending order here is 42, 19, 17 and 14. Alright, so this was ascending and descending order. The last two questions of descending order, try to do it for homework. So you have to write the greatest number first and the smallest last. Okay, so complete that for homework and we'll continue in the next class. Okay, thank you.